Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today is going to be part two of my Sephora VIB sale extravaganza. Anyway, I will put a little iCard somewhere about the part one. Forgot what I was saying. Anyway, if you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Janie and I post videos on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. And I do a little bit of everything as far as lifestyle, beauty, hauls, empties, book reviews, mask reviews. Just started getting into planner hauls and doing planner spreads. So if that's something that you would be interested in, hit the subscribe button and also click on that little bell icon so that you're notified of all future videos, because you don't want to miss the rest of the Sephora madness that is going on at my house right now. There's Sephora boxes everywhere. Anyway, thank you so much and let's get started. Okay, so I have a Sephora haul. Obviously, this is what this is called. But also, I'm going to put in my Beautylish haul. Beautylish last week did their gift card event where if you spent $100, then you got a $20 gift card. And for every $100, you got a $20 gift card. I did participated in that sale last year, and I saved my gift cards. So I was so proud of myself. I saved my gift cards since last year, and they expired at the end of December, so they were still good. But I used those gift cards to get this event and get these gift cards, and the gift cards that I have received in this Beautylish order, I'm going to use probably on the lucky bag. If Beautylish does a lucky bag, and if I'm lucky enough to be able to snag one. Anyway, so I'll start with Sephora, since by the title, that's what you probably came for. And Lordy B, have mercy on me. I got a lot of stuff. That was my medicine. I picked up my refills at the post office. Okay, let's see. Where do we want to start at? That was an Amazon haul item for my little sugar Gladys. Yeah. Okay, I want to start with this item here because I showed this in part one, and it is a lip gloss from Marc Jacobs. It's the Enamored High Shine Gloss in the color Hey You. I ordered this in my last order. So now I have two, but they are both going back because I actually have a little mini, and I put that in my purse this morning, so I have a little mini of the exact same color. And I was under the impression when I ordered it that it was going to be a red, and it is not. Well, I'm not going to open that because it's sealed, and I want them to be able to, it's not sealed on this end. Anyway, so let me show you. It is in the description, because I did go back and look, it does say it's like a cherry red or something like that, but to me that's just pink. That's nothing, that's not really cherry. And anyway, so it's going back because, like I said, I have a small one of this exact same color, so I'm not going to keep that. So anyway, okay. Some skincare, and this is from a really good Korean brand that Sephora carries, and it's called the Too Cool for School line, and this is the Pumpkin 24 Karat Gold Mask. I got three of them. I have not used these before, but so far, just about everything that I have tried from the Too Cool for School line, I have loved, so I wanted to get these to try, and I'm going to use one tonight, and if I like it, I may order some more of those this coming weekend when the VIB sale starts again. Anyway, and along the same lines as the Too Cool for School, another Too Cool for School item, and this is my Skinlicious Secret Pantry. I almost said panty. And this is a set of 5 sheets. 1 coconut ceramide mask and 4 egg cream mask. And this was $24. And of course, you know, you got the 20% off. But I'm going to open these and look at them. But I really like the egg cream mask. I have used that several times. Ugh. Okay. Oh, look how it's packaged. Isn't that cute? Anyway. Okay, the egg cream is for hydration. Another one for firming. Another one for pore. And then the ceramide mask. Anyway. Oh, okay. This is the coconut ceramide mask. That's pretty cool. And which is for... It says real coconut squeeze, 30% for hydration. This one here, the egg cream mask, I've used this, and definitely it is a really good hydrating mask. Love it. And there's actually 2 of those in there. Okay, yeah, it says that there was 2. I was thinking there was just going to be 1. Then this one for the pore tightening, and then this one for the firming. So, can't wait to use those. I love that brand. And when it first came out, I was just like, no, it looks too young for me. It's not mature enough for my skin because of the name and the little packaging, but I'm telling you, it works. It works really good. So far, the products that I've tried. Okay, I might as well just do, let me just do all of the skincare in this order. So I got this. This right here is from Glow Recipe, and it's the Watermelon Glow Sleepy Mask. It's for glowing radiance and softening. So here's the box, has a cute little watermelon. And then when you open the box, it has a little watermelon in there. Super cute. It has a little spatula in this little plastic wrap here. And then here is what the product looks like. Isn't that just a pretty pink? Oh, that's so pretty. That's probably my favorite hue of pink ever, right there. And I did open this earlier. I had to smell it. The only thing was when I opened it, there was no kind of seal right here. Is this supposed to have one? I don't know. I've never had this. And I've heard people talk about it, but I've never seen anybody actually, you know, get it brand new and show it. So, anyway. But yes, it does smell like watermelon. Like a watermelon Jolly Rancher. For sure. Oh. Smells so good. I cannot wait to use this. I got a sleepy mask in my last order. And then this sleepy mask. And you're going to see some more sleepy masks. I plan on doing a lot of sleeping. And masking. Because I am a woman. And I can multitask like that. Yes, I can. Okay, here's another product. This is from Laneige. Another Korean skincare line, and this is the Lip Sleepy Mask. Heard a lot of people talk about this and wanted to try it. Oh, look, it has a little scoop in it too. Oh, that's really cute. Oh, you're not going to be able to see that. Look at that. Oh, it's so cute. It's got a little pink scoop on the end. Anyway, and... Oh, see, it has a little thing in there. Why did that other one not? That makes me kind of worried. Anyway. Oh, yeah. Does it smell like anything? I don't... Smell a little bit like a sweet tart. I mean, I've heard people say it smells a little bit like candy, so not a whole lot of scent going on there. Okay. So we have that. Ooh, let me put that little scoop back in there so I don't lose that. Okay. And then from Laneige. How do you say that? You know, it's funny. You can sit and watch 100 videos on a product, and then when you get that product and you go to do a video or talk about it, you can't pronounce it to save your life. You don't remember how. Anyway, this was a little kit, a little travel kit, a little trial kit of, and it's for hydrating. They had several different ones. This says bring me, I guess, for travel, and it's in this cute little sack here, a bag that I'm getting ready to open up. I talked about in my intro that I just started into planning, and look, it has stickers in it, and they got bent up. Look at the stickers. Oh gosh, and they got bent up. Oh, I didn't know it had stickers in there. That's pretty cool. Anyway, so it has stickers, and then it has. Let's get back to the age that I really am, and not a 5-year-old. This is the Laneige Cleaning Moisturizing Foam Cleanser, which is going to be really good because, you know, we're getting into the winter months. We've started running our heat. You probably just heard it click off, and I'm going to need all the moisturization that I can possibly get. That is not going to focus, is it? Anyway, so I got that was in the little kit, and that's a really good size sample. One fluid ounce. Then there was the essential toner, skin toner, for normal to dry skin, which is a pretty good, again, a good size sample. And then the essence, the water, what is this called? The water something. The water bank essence, and that's a pretty small container, but that's okay. Give you a good, that's probably at least a good week's, 2 weeks worth of product to give a try. Then it has in here the moisture cream, and then the sleepy mask for the face, the water sleepy mask. So have that. Another sleepy mask. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. I love masks. I talk about this all the time. If you're not doing masking in some way, some form in your skincare regime, you're missing out. You're missing the boat on having really, really good skin. Okay, now to the makeup items in this order. I didn't order a whole lot of makeup. It's mostly skincare, as you see. Mostly skincare. Let me gather some of this up and get this box out of the way. There we go. So, I wanted to try this little guy here from Hourglass. This is the Ambient Metallic Strobe Lighting Palette. And I've heard a lot of people talk and say that this is supposed to be really good for people with mature skin like myself that wants a glow but not glitter, not pieces of glitter. So I did get this, and it looks like I opened this earlier today. Here in here, it looks like somebody's already swatched it. So I may just take this back. Plan on doing with my daughter, hopefully in the next couple weekends, not this coming weekend but the following weekend, a little girl's day, because I want to go and do my Christmas shopping before it gets totally crazy at the mall. But look at that. So I may take it and exchange it. Oh, that's so pretty though. That does look pretty though. And I was kind of reluctant to get it because of this color, because this is more of a bronzy. But I think I can pull that off. If nothing else, on the eyelid, that would be really pretty. So, anyway. So, got that. And then the other makeup item that I got was from Kat Von D, and this was a little mini. I talked about that in my last video that kind of a little ham on getting minis. But anyway, this is the Kat Von D Saint perfume, because she just came back out with the Saint and Center. I would have got Center, but the lipstick that came with it was a color I knew I wouldn't wear, so I may just order Center on its own as opposed to in this kit. But it does say that the lipstick in here is a new shade, and it is called, I don't know what it's called, but anyway, here's the perfume. And I was thinking this was a rollerball, but it's not, it's actually a spray. So, and it definitely has some vanilla to it, so I'm not really for sure how I'm going to like that, but there's another reason why I bought it, and I'll tell you that here in just a moment. And then the lipstick is this color here, and this is called, what is this called? Oh, Saint. It's called Saint, and it's supposed to be a peachy rose, and it's just a little mini, but that's okay, because I have a ton of lipsticks. Oh, where do I put that? It's right there. It's pretty. It's really pretty. So it's right there. And that kit was not very expensive at all. It was around $20, $25, $20, I think. So I'm surprised more people aren't talking about these little kits with that in there. But anyway. So I did get that, and then the last thing for this Sephora order, whoo, my stuff about fell over, there we go, is this little kit here from Elizabeth and James, and this is the Nirvana set. Oh, look at the packaging of this. This is so pretty. It's like watercolors, even the back. I mean, look at the little different ones, but anyway, it has the black, the bourbon, the white, and the rose. And I thought that the Saint that I got, that I just showed you, would pair really, really good with the rose. So anyway, but look at this little set of these little bitty minis. They're so cute. The only thing is, I thought that they were going to be a spray, but they are not. They are a dabber, so... Look how cute those are. And my friend that collects perfume bottles, when I get done with these, she's going to be so excited to have these. But anyway, it's just a little dabber, see, like that. But oh, give them a try. I really wanted to try this bourbon. Oh, that smells good. Oh, ooh, that smells good. So anyway, so I got that. And it wasn't that expensive, so to give that a try. Okay, so that was it for the Sephora. I do have some more Sephora orders coming, but we'll have to do those later because I don't have them in yet. So I'm going to show you what I got from Beautylish. And I've already opened it too, partially. Okay. I'll show you here in a minute. I didn't see those. So, let me pull out all of my stuff. And if you've never ordered from Beautylish before, they have wonderful, wonderful shipping. I mean, they get it to you so fast. Now, with this sale, it was delayed a little bit because they were so busy, but... Normally, you can order something from Beautylish and have it at your door within 24 hours. That's really good. And the way they package it, it's just so cool. Because they go the extra step, I guess, to package. And one of the things that they do, I'll show you here, is they put this paper. And usually, it's different kinds of paper. And then they put a little... label here to hold it down, and this is called From the Ordinary, but I saved this paper because I have some from last year that was in from my lucky bag that was really, really pretty, and I used it to line the shelf in my bathroom. I have a little cabinet, like a linen cabinet, and I used that to line that shelf. It's not shelf paper, but it worked. It was really pretty, so. But yeah, it's just, I don't know. I don't know what it is that just appeals to me. I mean, it's just plain paper with squares on it, but anyway, okay. Enough about the paper. Let's get into the product. So, here is some items right here, and I don't know, but I'm thinking I didn't get everything. Did I not get everything? We'll see. We'll see when we open it. Anyway, the little packaging that they do, they wrap their stuff up in this brown paper, and then they put this little string around it to tie it. It just makes me think of something like along the lines of Little House on the Prairie, you know, this would be how they would wrap their present, you know, Little House on the Prairie or the Waltons. Anyway, it's just cute. I like it. I mean, it's plain, but I like it. I think it's really neat. I wish every brand would wrap their stuff like this. Anyway, it's just a little sack. I mean, that's all it is, just a little brown paper sack, but they, so enamored with that, but okay. It's actually more in the sack than I thought there was. That's what I was thinking. I don't think I got everything that I ordered, but I did. I did. What did I order? Oh, yeah. I forgot I ordered this. This right here, we'll just start with this because I forgot I ordered it. This is from the Natasha Denona, and it's the Photogen E Perfect Finish HD Foundation in the color number 2 Nude. You're probably not going to be able to see that because of the white packaging. Possibly, maybe, maybe not. I don't know. Anyway, so I ordered that. I was in the market for some new foundations, and this was one that I wanted to try. And let's do a little swatch here. I don't like heavy foundations. I don't need full coverage. And full coverage, when someone on my age just creaks and cracks and moans and groans and doesn't look good. So, but anyway, there it is. I mean, it blended right in. It's pretty. We'll have to see. So anyway, I got that. And then I got the Embrulisse Concentrate, Latique Cream Concentrate. Anyway, a lot of people talk about this. They swear by it. They think it's a wonderful primer. And I am in the market for a new primer, so I thought I would give this a try for a primer. And so I just got the, I think this was like the medium size. One thing about this brand, it's not very expensive at all, which is nice. Sometimes brands think too much of their product and overprice it way, way, way too much. And then I did get some items from the Ordinary. I got the lactic acid 10% plus HA 2%. I've already used up a whole bottle of this. I think this is comparable to the Sunday Riley Good Jeans, which is about triple the price of this. I think it works just as good. And it looks like some of it's gone. But I'm just paranoid. I'm paranoid because I was on the way home and my husband calls me. He's like, "Do I need to send the police?" I'm like, "What are you talking about?" He goes, "Well, the alarm went off, the motion, whoa, 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 come back. The motion detector in the garage is tripped and the alarm went off. I'm like, well, I'm not even home yet. He was on his way to a meeting, so he's like, well, go home and check it out. Like, you know, with the stupid time change, it's dark already. So I'm coming home to a dark house looking for the booger man. So now everything's just kind of a little out of sorts. I have almost every light on the house, in the house on. I have lights outside on. So I have the alarm set, so if something happens, all I gotta do is just open the door, break a window or something, and just set the alarm off. We live in Muskogee. Muskogee's a little rough. Which I'm sure it's just like any town. One street will be really nice. You go on a turn and go on the next street and you're in the ghetto. So anyway. Okay. Another product from The Ordinary. This I have not tried. This is something new. Oh, and I'm not going to be able to say this. Anyway, it's a vitamin C. It's a high strength oil. Solubilized. I don't know how to say that. Vitamin C with vitamin F. Anyway, I've been trying to find a alternative vitamin C product that would replace my Drunk Elephant Pharmacy serum because it's so expensive. So I'm going to give this a try. And this is a new product that they just came out with. So I'm going to give it a try and see. Okay. Let me get a makeup wipe and change my battery and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So the next couple things that I got from Beautylish were a couple of Inglot eyeshadows. I was needing a matte, deeper brown to kind of go with my Inglot. Not that I needed it. I mean, I have other matte, dark brown eyeshadows, but when I'm using my Inglot, I want to use everything Inglot. Are y'all like that? Anyway, it looks like that there. Hoping that that is... These are the hardest things ever to open. When everybody was talking about Inglot, I had ordered a ton off the Inglot website, and probably like at least 15, maybe even 20 eyeshadows, and they were all this hard to open. Oh, they are super hard to get open. They definitely don't want you to open. Anyway, okay, there we go. And this is the color 376. They don't have names, they just have numbers, and I told you wrong, it's 378. Yeah, 378. So there's the swatch of it. It's almost like a taupe. It's not the chocolate brown that I thought it was going to be. Oh man, you know what? That's not even brown. That's purple. Purpley color. I mean, it's pretty. But that's not what I thought it was. And then the other one is number 329. Anyway, if you're not familiar with Inglot, they're very inexpensive eyeshadows. They're like $7 a piece. You can put them in. They have little palettes that you can buy and put them in. And those are very inexpensive also. And at one time, kind of like, you know, a lot of things on YouTube, at one time, you know, everybody was talking about Inglot, and now nobody hardly ever talks about Inglot. They've moved on to probably Makeup Geek, ColourPop, you know how it is. I can't get this open. I'm telling you. You can't get them open. This one's actually the chocolate brown. This one I thought was supposed to be burgundy. This was supposed to be a burgundy color. And it's more like a purpley mauve. I mean, it's still pretty. I'm not going to send it back. And it will work very nicely in my collection. I'm trying to make small talk here. Well, I can't get it open. I'm sorry. I can't get it open. We've got to move on. Then I ordered something from Charlotte Tilbury. Cannot talk. And this is the matte liquid lipstick in the color, I don't know. What? Oh. I thought it said instant glamour in a tree, but it says instant glamour in a tube. I'm really going to have to start bringing my glasses in here. There's just all there is to it. I can't tell what color it is. What the name of the color? Here, let me look on my sheet. Oh, that's not it. Scream Siren. Scream Siren. Which is, ta-da-da, a red color. Y'all knew that. I knew it was going to be red, but I wanted to try her liquid lipstick. I don't know. It seems to be kind of patchy. I don't know about that. I'm not too impressed. It has a little bit of a vanilla smell to it, which I guess everybody makes their lipstick smell like that. I'm smelling it. There it is. So, okay. So that's all of the cosmetics. Oh, I was going to show you these little stickers that they sent also with the Ordinary products so that you can put on there. So you can put on there if you're going to use it at morning, at night. If you're going to use it one time weekly, three times weekly, if you need to use your SPF, okay, because some of these products, because of the way that the Ordinary does, you know, it's one product, and so, you know, they may have the niacinamide, and then vitamin C, and then hyaluronic acid, and certain things you shouldn't mix together, and so these little labels will help you to put on there if you should or shouldn't mix with them. I wish they would have done this when I first bought the Ordinary, because I have a little list, a little sheet that I keep in my medicine cabinet, that I know exactly what days I'm supposed to use what, and that way I don't mix something that's not supposed to be mixed. So anyway, but I thought that was pretty neat. So some more little stickers. I like stickers. And then also some little pamphlets for each of the different ones that I ordered to kind of talk about it, and probably, yeah, precautions, maybe what not to mix with it. Yeah, so anyway. Okay, so now let's get down to the exciting part of this order that I was waiting till they were doing this gift card event again before I ordered these products so that I could get more gift cards and use my gift cards. And they came in this cute little bag that says Beautylish on it. Just a little cloth zip up bag. And they're in a little roll like this. You may be familiar with the roll. And this is what I got, the Wayne Goss. This is the Wayne Goss, the face set. And these are brushes that Wayne Goss, who is a very well-known makeup artist and YouTuber, he collabed with Beautylish several years ago and created his own brush line. They are made in Japan. They're made, I think, exactly like the Chikahoda brushes would be. It's supposed to be very, very good quality brushes. I do have a few of his brushes that I received in the Lucky Bags. So, and again, just wrapped up, so cute and it's pretty. And I know that Trish from A Glittery Life really speaks highly of the Wayne Goss brushes, and also Kristen from Kristen Game. Anyway, this is what the brush set looks like. And this is for the face. You get the number 11, the number 15, which is a fan brush. I really wanted the fan brush. And the number 14, the number 12, the number 13, and then the number 10. I can't really tell you a whole lot about them because I'm really not for sure. Got that versed in them. Let's see. I'm thinking that the original set that he came out with was made with Blue Squirrel, and then these, the white ones, are made with goat hair. So, oh my gosh, that's so soft. So, I cannot wait to use those. I wanted them. I've been wanting them for a long time, and finally decided that this year was going to be the year I got them. I got another set also, and this is the eye set. Darn it. I took my nails off a couple days ago. I can't hardly do anything because my nails are sore from cutting them down. Still has a little care card in there, and they are wrapped up the same. This came off. Anyway. A lot smaller than I thought they would be. Oh, look at those. They're so pretty. The number 18. Number 20. Oh, I like that one. That's a really small crease brush. That's going to be good. The number 17. The number 16. And then the number 19. After I use these for a little bit, I'll kind of tell you my opinions and thoughts on them after I've played with them. So that's what I got from Beautylish. I have just one more thing. Oh, and then my gift cards. Here's my gift cards that they sent to me to use. I can't show them to them because it has my code on there, and it's a one-time use. But I'm not going to tell you how many gift cards I have. But anyway, I'm going to use those. Okay, so I have one more order here, and this I ordered from Kojendo. And I wanted to, like I said earlier, I'm in the market for a new foundation. And I've been wanting to try the Kojendo, but I have no place where I can actually go and swatch the colors of it. So if you go on their website, you can order a sample packet. And then when you get your packet in, they send you a code to get $10 off of a foundation. So you pretty much get your money back on your little sample packs. So I think I got two different sample packs. I think it was like $12. Yeah, it was $12. And there was no shipping. The problem was when I got it, well, my invoice, can you see? They exploded. Look in that. Look, it exploded. And not only in that pack, but this pack too, in both packs, they exploded. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to use them. But I did get some for the Aqua Foundation and the Moisture Foundation. So, and the sample pack number one in both of those, which would have been the lighter colors. And it's just like, oh, they exploded. And you know, you hate to contact them for something like that. I mean, look. So, but there's tons of samples in here. Gosh, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 samples. So, hopefully I can salvage them and be able to figure out a color so that I can order a color. I was going to get it during the Sephora VIB sale because it's so expensive, but I may just order from now. Anyway. Yeah. So that was kind of sad. So I'm going to have to clean all these off and figure out what happened. Why did they explode? Anyway. So that is it for this long drawn out haul. I hope that you have enjoyed and have stuck with me. Don't forget to give me a big old thumbs up. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye.